you know, the Bible.
那我今天就要来解释说呢，要怎么样来解释圣经。
There are two aspects, yeah, as far as our beliefs are concerned.
那在我们的信仰上面呢，有两个方面要来注意。
When we talk about the Word of God, there are two aspects.
那当我们说到神的话呢，有两个方面。
One is the doctrines of the church, the basic belief of the church.
那第一个就是呢，教会的教义，我们的基本教义。
And the second is what we call, teachings pertaining to our spiritual cultivation.
那下第二个呢，就是呢，关于灵修的一些教训。
These two aspects are interrelated and they cannot be isolated from one another.
那这两个呢，是息息相关，不可以分开来说的。
When we talk about general teachings, we are talking about cultivational teachings, which we must learn in order to live a godly life.
那我们说到一般的教训呢，是我们需要学习到才能过着敬虔的生活。
However, our godly life can only be built up if we have this strong foundation, doctrinal foundation.
但是呢，要有这个敬虔的生活，我们现在要建立在有这个教义的基础上。
So we cannot remove the doctrines of the church and try to build up our spiritual life.
那所以呢，如果没有这个教义的基础呢，我们没办法建立起我们的属灵。
Because the doctrines or the basic belief of the church are the foundations.
因为这个教会的基础，这个基本教义呢，就是这个根基。
So for this session, I'm going to talk about how to explain, the doctrines of the church.
那所以呢，我们这一节要来谈到怎么样来解释基本的教义。
I guess when we talk to our Christian friends, we might have encountered many questions.
那就像我们跟我们的基督教朋友在谈的时候呢，可能会遇到一些问题。
Sometimes we find it difficult to explain some of the questions or to answer some of the questions raised by them.
那有时候他们提出的问题，我们没办法来好好的来回答来解释。
I guess there are two points that we need to bear in mind.
那有两点我们要谨记。
First, the doctrines of the church are revealed to us by God in a form or in a pattern.
那首先呢，就是这个教义呢，是神有一个规模，有一个这个规矩来告诉我们的。
We turn to the book of Romans, chapter 6.
我们看罗马书第六章。
Please turn to the book of Romans, chapter 6.
罗马书第六章。
We read verse 17.
17节。
Romans, chapter 6, verse 17.
六章十七节。
But God be thanked that though you were slaves of sin, yet you obeyed from the heart that form of doctrine to which you were delivered.
七节，感谢神，因为你们从前虽然做罪的奴仆，现今却从心里顺服了所传给你们道理的规的模范。
Paul is reminding the believers at Rome concerning how God has saved them.
那这里保罗提醒罗马的信徒，神怎么样来拯救他们？
They are saved by obeying, the form of doctrine that they were preached to.
他们得救呢，是因为顺服了所传给他们的道理的模范。
We understand that God is an orderly God.
我们知道神是一个有模范、有规矩的神。
So whatever He has given to us, is easily understandable if we are able to grasp the form or the pattern that He has given to us.
所以呢，神要我们明白的是有次序，是有一个模范的。
This form of doctrine is also given, has also been given to the true Jesus Church.
那这同样的教义呢，也传给了我们的真耶稣教会。
We always encourage our brothers and sisters that they must honor the doctrine that the church has received from God.
那我们都说呢，我们信徒呢要来尊重神传给我们教会的这些规模。
The patterns of sound words represents the collective wisdom that God has given to the church.
那纯正会的规模呢，是神所赏赐给我们的。
Now, therefore, we must believe in it.
对，我们要相信。
Now, you find that when we believe in the Word of God, believe in the doctrines of the church, more understanding shall be given to us.
如果我们相信的话，这个教义，这个神的话呢，我们就会更加的明白。
Meaning more understanding of the doctrine shall be granted, shall be imparted to us.
那就是呢，这个教义的这个经义呢，我们就会更加的清楚。
I guess we all have this experience ourselves before.
那我相信我们都有过这样的经历。
Sometimes, you know, some questions are raised against our belief, which we are not able to answer, you know, easily.
那就是有人对我们的信仰来提出一些问题，我们却没有办法来容易的或是好好的来回答。
But we need to understand that, you know, our inability to answer questions raised against our belief does not mean that our beliefs are not correct.
但是呢，我们要知道说，我们自己无法去回答这些问题，不代表说这些信仰就是错误的。
Our inability to answer questions does not warrant us to change the beliefs of the church.
那我们无法来这个解释这个道理，也不能改变说这个神的话语的这个能力。
Rather, we have to adopt a correct attitude.
但是我们有一个好这个正确的态度。
That is, we need to rely more on God to understand the doctrines so that we can answer question raised against our doctrines.
我们要来更依靠神来回答这些问题。
So meaning we must trust in the Lord.
那就是我们要来信靠神。
So when we do that, you find that, you know, the doctrines of the church will become clearer and clearer to us.
那如果越信靠神呢，这个教义呢，这个教训呢，我们就会更加的清晰明白。
So we must believe in the words or the word of truth that we have received.
我们要来相信神这真理的话语。
We turn to First Thessalonians.
看帖撒罗尼迦前书。
We read chapter 2.
我们看第二章。
Verse 13, yeah, chapter 2, verse 13.
二章十三节。
For this reason, we also thank God without ceasing, because when you receive the word of God, which you heard from us, you welcome it not as the word of man, but as if is in truth the word of God, which also effectively works in you who believe.
三节，所以我们也不住的感谢神，因你们听见我们所传神的道，就领受了，不以为是人的道，乃以为是神的道。这道实在是神的，并且运行在你们信主的人心中。
You find that when we believe, yeah, then the word or the truth, in this case, the basic belief of the church would work effectively in us.
所以当我们相信这个神的话、神的道，这个教义呢，就会在我们心中来运行。
Meaning that we will come to understand the doctrines of the church more and more.
那就是呢，我们会来明白教会的教义，然后就是越来越清楚的。
So before we can explain the doctrine of the church, we must also rely on God to keep the patterns of sound words.
在我们能够解释教会的教义之前呢，我们要求神来保守这个纯正话语的规模。
We turn to 2 Timothy chapter 1.
我们看提摩太后书第一章。
2 Timothy chapter 1.
提摩太后书第一章。
We read verse 13 and verse 14.
十三十四节。
Verse 13 and verse 14.
十三十四节。
Hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me in faith and love which are in Christ Jesus.
十三节，你从我听的那纯正话语的规模，要用在基督耶稣里的信心和爱心，常常守着。
Timothy was told to hold fast to the patterns of sound words which he had heard from Paul.
那这里保罗提醒提摩太呢，要来守住那听见的纯正话语规模。
How could he keep this word of God effectively?
这个神的话要怎么样 来 有效率的守着呢？
We read verse 14.
14节。
That good thing which was committed to you, keep by the Holy Spirit who dwells in us.
从前所交付你的善道，你要靠着那住在我们里面的圣灵牢牢的守着。
Here we can see that one of the functions of the Holy Spirit is to help us keep the sound words or the patterns of sound words that we have heard.
那圣灵其中一个功能就是帮助我们来守住那纯正话语的规模。
It is virtually impossible for us to explain the doctrines clearly if we have not kept or if we do not keep the patterns of sound words by the power of the Holy Spirit.
如果我们不是借着圣灵来守住那纯正话语的规模，我们是无法、不可能将神的话来好好的解释的。
You know, when we pray about our own beliefs, our own faith,
当我们在为我们的信仰来祷告的时候,
you find that the Spirit in our hearts will begin to work within us to teach us more of the basic beliefs.
我们发现我们心中的圣灵会教导我们 来巩固这个基本的教义,
to make our understanding stronger.
然后让我们能够有更清楚的明白。
Because we keep relying on the Holy Spirit, therefore our understanding of the doctrine surely shall be better.
那因为我们是来靠着圣灵要来守住的，那我们的知识也会来增加。
Now we also read John.
我们看约翰福音。
Now John chapter 16.
16章。
John chapter 16.
约翰福音十六章。
We read verse 13.
我们看十三节。
16 verse 13.
十六章十三节。
However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth, for he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come.
十三节。只等真理的圣灵来了，他要引导你们明白一切的真理，因为他不是凭自己说的，乃是把他所听见的都说出来，并要把将来的事告诉你们。
Here we are told that the Spirit, when he comes, shall lead us into all truth.
那这里说呢，圣灵来了之后，他要带领我们进入一切的真理。
When Jesus talks about this, and obviously he must have the word of truth in mind.
当耶稣提到这个的时候，他心中有一切的真理。
真理的道。
有真理的道。
So meaning, he wants his disciple to be led by the Spirit into the words of truth.
所以他也要这个门徒呢，也一样进入这一切的真理。
Meaning that, you know, when the Spirit comes, there shall be given a greater understanding.
意思就是圣灵来了，他们就会来明白这些道理。
Today we have the Holy Spirit. We can pray that the Spirit will lead us into the basic belief of the church.
今天我们有圣灵的同在，我们也可以求圣灵带领我们进入一切的真理。
We find that, you know, the doctrines of the church, we said, are given to us by God.
那我们知道教会的教义是神所赐给教会的。
If the church has not received, you know, a certain aspects of the doctrines, then no one can actually understand the doctrine in full.
那因为如果教会没有领受这个教义的规模的话，没有人能够明白这些。
Let me give you a very simple example. Yeah.
我们就讲一个简单的例子。
We always say that, you know, baptism must be done with facing forward.
那我们就讲说这个洗礼呢，我们知道要头面向下。
You find that this aspect actually was revealed to the early workers.
那这一点呢，就是在早期的工人身上是来显明给他们的。
we according to the history of the church, the first seed of the true Jesus church was baptized by the Holy Spirit.
我们知道教会的第一个种子呢，是由圣灵来为他受洗的。
He was told to go to a river to bow his head and to immerse himself into the water.
他被叫到呢，这个要到河流的里面，然后呢，头向下来受洗。
I want you to turn to John chapter 19.
我们看约翰福音十九章。
John chapter 19.
约翰福音十九章。
We read verse 30.
我们看三十节。
Because we believe in the revelation of God to the early workers.
因为我们相信了神对这个早期工人的启示。
Therefore, when we read John 19, we can make sense of Christ bowing his head on the cross before he died.
那我们就明白十九章耶稣在死之前他低头的这个意义。
We read verse 30.
我们看三十节。
So when Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, "It is finished." And bowing his head, he gave up his spirit.
三十节，耶稣尝了那醋，就说成了，便低下头，将灵魂交付神了。
Because the first seed of our church was baptized with his head facing forward.
那我们教会第一粒种子呢？这个就是低下头来接受洗礼。
He was told by the Holy Spirit, you know, to bow his head.
是圣灵来告诉他要这样子低下头的。
This is like, you know, the pattern that God has given to the church.
那这就是神教导教会的这个规模。
Because we believe in that.
因为我们相信这一点。
That's why we can actually find support in the Bible.
那我们就可以在圣经上来找到这个支持。
Now, you can imagine if this is not disclosed to the early worker, then none of us would have, you know, understood the importance of bowing head in water baptism.
我们想象一下，如果圣灵没有将这件事情来启发给早期工人，我们不会知道说这个受洗的时候要这样子去做。
Because a form has been given to the church.
那是因为这个规模来赏赐给了教会。
We turn to Romans chapter 6.
我们看罗马书第六章。
We look at Romans chapter 6.
罗马书第六章。
We read verse 5. Yeah.
我们看第五节。
Romans chapter 6 verse 5.
罗马书六章五节。
For if we have been united together in the likeness of his death, certainly we also shall be in the likeness of his resurrection.
五节，我们若在他死的形状上与他联合，也要在他复活的形状上与他联合。
We find that we can easily link this verse to John chapter 19, verse 30.
那我们就可以将这一节还有约翰福音十九章三十节来做一个连结。
Now we are able to do that again because we have first been given the form of baptism, how baptism should be done.
那我们能够做到这一点，就是因为一开始呢，有被圣灵启发，告诉我们这个洗礼要怎么样来去实行。
That's why when we search into the scriptures, we find that you know, baptism with head facing forward is biblical.
那之后我们在查考圣经的时候，就来查证说这个低下头受洗是符合圣经的。
This is how we explain, for example, you know, head facing facing forward, our head must face forward in baptism.
那就是我们怎么来解释说为什么受洗的时候要来低下头来接受洗礼。
Now, I want to give you another example.
那我们再看另外一个例子。
If you look at the teachings of the church concerning the Holy Spirit.
那我们看到这个教会这个圣灵的这个教义。
You know, one of the points is that, you know, the Spirit,would come down in two different periods of time.
那我们看到说圣灵呢会在两个时期来降下。
We believe that the Spirit would had come down on the day of Pentecost.
我们知道这个圣灵在早期的五旬节已经降下。
And now the Spirit the Spirit continues to be poured upon us today.
那是今天呢，这个圣灵也持续的在我们身上降下。
How can we, you know, find support in the Bible?
那我们怎么样在圣经上找到支持？
Now, you find that if we don't have this understanding, then many of the passages in the Old Testament, when we read them, they will not make sense to us.
所以呢，如果我们没有这样的理解，我们在读旧约的时候就不会明白。
Now, for example, we talk about the early rain and the latter rain.
那比如说我们说到早雨跟晚雨。
We can look at Deuteronomy.
我们看生命记。
We turn to the book of Deuteronomy.
生命记。
We read chapter 11.
十一章。
Chapter 11.
生命记第十一章。
Okay, we can read. We read from verse 11. We read verse 11 first.
我们先读十一节。
But the land which you cross over to possess is a land of hills and valleys, which drains water from the rain of heaven.
你们要过去得为业的那地，乃是有山有谷、雨水滋润之地。
This is the promise of the Lord, yeah?
这是主的应许。
That when they cross over to the promised land, and then, you know, God will shower, you will give them rain.
他们过去那得为业之地之后，神会赏赐雨水给他们。
We drop down to verse 14.
我们看14节。
Then I will give you the rain for your land in this season, the early rain and the latter rain, that you may gather in your grain, your new wine, and your oil.
它必按时降秋雨、春雨在你们的地上，使你们可以收藏五谷、新酒和油。
Now, here it talks about early rain and latter rain.
那这里提到早雨、晚雨，就是秋雨、春雨。
You know, if you look at the geography of the land of Palestine,
那如果我们看巴勒斯坦的这个地理环境，
We understand that this two period of rains are like seasonal rains.
那这两段时期的雨就是他们的季节的雨。
They call it the early rain and the latter rain.
就他们称为秋雨跟春雨。
You know, the early rain comes to soften the soil so that, you know, when the seed are sown, you know, and the seed could easily grow.
所以早雨降下呢，来滋润土壤，然后让这个土壤充满了雨水，让这个种子能够成长。
Now the latter rain is the rain that would come before the harvest is done.
那晚雨呢，就是在收割之前的这一场雨。
You know, we take this to mean the two period of rains that would come in the history of humanity.
那这两场雨也是在人类史上的这两场雨。
And we believe that when the rain comes, then the church of God would be established.
那我们相信呢，这两场雨下来的时候呢，神的教会就建立起来。
Because we have this understanding.
那因为我们明白这一点。
So when we read the Bible, yeah, like the prophecy in Joel,
然后当我们看到这个约珥书的预言的时候，
so it becomes very clear to us.
那我们一看就是非常的清晰。
Because we first have these patterns that God has given to the church.
因为我们首先在这个教会上有这样子的规模。
We can turn to Joel.
我们看约珥书。
Joel chapter 2.
约珥书第二章。
Joel chapter 2, we read verse 23.
二十三节。
Joel chapter 2, verse 23.
二章二十三节。
And be glad then, you children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given you the former rain faithfully, and he will cause the rain to come down for you.The former rain and the latter rain in the first month.
二十三节，锡安的民啊，你们要快乐，为耶和华你们的神欢喜，因他赐给你们合宜的秋雨，为你们降下甘霖，就是秋雨、春雨和先前一样。
In this prophecy, you find that this period of rain is all are only given to the door to the children of Zion.
那我发现这两场雨是赏赐给锡安的民的。
Now meaning is like prophetically speaking, yeah, it points to a specific group of people.
那所以在预言的上事实上就是指着特定的选民。
Only the children of Zion shall receive this two period of rains.
只有这锡安的民会领受到这两场雨。
When we read the Bible, we understand Zion represents the chosen people of God.
我们读圣经知道，这锡安就代表着神的选民。
So meaning the rain, the Holy Spirit shall only be given to those who belongs to Him.
就是这个雨，这个圣灵会赏赐给那属于神的那些人。
Quite clearly, anyone who is not a part of Mount Zion, then the rain shall not be given.
那很清楚的，不属于那锡安的民就不会领受到这雨。
So sometimes, you know, people may question, may ask.
所以有人就会来问我们这些问题。
Apart from TJC, do you think other churches also have the Holy Spirit?
除了真耶稣教会之外，你觉得其他教会也有圣灵吗？
Now, if you have this pattern of soundward, then obviously your answer is a resounding no.
那如果你有这话语的规模，你就会很知道说你要回答是否定的。
Because it is not possible, because the rain here, prophetically speaking,is only given to the children of Zion.
因为这是不可能，因为在预言上就已经说到这雨只会向下在锡安的民。
So you find that, you know, when on the day of Pentecost, when you know, the Spirit first came down.
所以在五旬节当天圣灵降下的时候，
Peter actually, you know, like spoke a sermon.
彼得在那边讲道。
He based his sermon actually on the book of Joel.
他的道理呢，就是讲这个约珥书。
Talking about, you know, the promise of the Holy Spirit.
讲到这应许的圣灵。
So you find that, you know, our understanding concerning the two period of rains actually is accurate, prophetically speaking.
所以我们知道，我们对这两场雨的认知是这个正确的。
You know, some people may question.
那有人会直问说，
apart from these two periods of rain, if you look at, you know, the land of Palestine, in between, there is also, you know, a season of rain.
那就是在这两个时节的雨之外，在巴勒斯坦也其中间也是有下雨。
Because in between these periods, these two rainy season is the winter.
因为在这两个雨季之间是冬季。
So they will have a lot of wintry shower.
所以会有很多这个冬季的雨。
So people said, you know, how can your understanding of this two period of rain be accurate?
那人家就是说，那你对这两个时节的这个雨怎么会是解读是正确的呢？
If you said the early rain represents the coming of the Spirit on the day of Pentecost, you know, on the early church,and the latter rain, you know, represents the Spirit coming upon the true Jesus Church.
如果你说这个早雨是这个早期在这个五旬节降下，在这个早期的教会上，晚雨是降下在真耶稣教会这个晚雨的这个时候。
What about the showers in between?
那在这之间的这些雨水呢？
No, according to the teachings of the Bible.
根据圣经的教训。
For example, when you look at the last few books of the New Testament scriptures,
比如说我们看到新约的最后几卷书，
you know, the writers, yeah, most of them actually address the issues concerning heresies.
这个作者呢都提到有关于这个异端的事情。
So meaning that the church at the time was badly affected by heretic teachings.
就是当时的教会呢，这个被异端严重的侵扰。
When we trace the history of the church,
当我们来追溯当时教会的历史，
especially after all the apostles had died,
特别是在这些使徒呢在去世之后，
you find that, you know, many of the teachings of the apostles were changed.
我发现使徒的这些教训已经很多的都被更改了。
We know that the Spirit is the truth, and the truth is the Spirit. If the truth is changed, then obviously the Spirit will depart.
我们知道圣灵就是真理，真理就是圣灵。如果真理改变了，这圣灵就会离开。
So quite clearly, we know that, you know, after the apostle, all of them had died, the Spirit left the church.
所以在这个使徒结这个使徒时期结束之后呢，那这个真理就没有了。
But even if we want to assign meaning to the reign in between, we still can do it.
但是如果你要在这两个语句之间的语来给它赋予意义的话，还是可以的。
We know if you look at the early church after the death of the apostle.
那我们看这个使徒过世之后的这个教会。
And then all the way to the time that the true Jesus church came into being.
直到这真耶稣教会来出现。
We can see the work of God in between these two periods.
还是能够看见神的这个工作在运行。
Even though, you know, the truth was no longer there.
虽然真理已经不在了。
But you find that, you know, the work of God continue on.
但是我们发现神的工作还是持续的在运作。
For example, you know, the canonization of the Bible.
比如说这个圣经的
经典化。And also, you find that the translation of the Bible.
还有这个圣经被这个翻译。
All this like were done in preparation for the emergence of the end time true church.
这些工作呢都是为了真耶稣教会出现的准备工作。
So yes, the truth has been lost you know, after the death of the apostle.
没错，这个使徒过世之后呢，这个真理已经流失了。
But you can see that God actually has done a lot of preparation work, you know, for the existence of the true Jesus Church.
但是我们看到神呢，在这之间呢，做了很多的预备工作来使真教会来出现。
So that when the true Jesus Church came into being, you know, you'll find that, you know, we will have this Bible, a complete Bible.
所以当真耶稣教会出现的时候，我们就有这完备的圣经。
In different languages.
然后有各种的语言的翻译版本。
These are the works of God.
这些都是神的工作。
How can we come to, you know, this kind of conclusion?
那我们怎么来画下一个这个结论？
Because we have the pattern first given.
因为我们首先领受了这个规模。
So when we believe that this pattern is correct,
所以当我发现这个模范呢 是正确的。
No matter how we challenge, we'll find answers to those questions raised against us.
不论人家的怎么来挑战我们都能够找到这真理的印证。
We understand that, you know, the doctrines are given to us by God.
我们知道这个教义是神给我们的。
And therefore, the doctrines would not contradict or do not contradict any parts of the Bible.
所以这个教义呢，绝对不会跟圣经上任何一处来抵触。
We find that if the doctrines are not from God but are from man,
但是如果教义不是从神来，是从人来的。
You find that, you know, sooner or later, you know, these doctrines will be challenged and find that they contradict actually many parts of the Bible.
迟早呢，可以在这个圣经上来找到不相同然后来抵触的地方。
Now, I just want to give you two examples to explain to you that our doctrines, the doctrine of the true Jesus Church, do not contradict any part of the Bible.
那我想用两个例子来解释呢，真耶稣教会的教义绝不会跟教会的这个不会跟圣经来抵触。
Because the doctrines are given by God and obviously it cannot be wrong.
因为这个教义是从神所给的，所以绝对不会有不同的地方。
Because God knows exactly what He would want to convey to the church.
因为神知道他要传达给教会的讯息是什么。
And He also knows what the church will face in the future.
神也知道教会将要来面临的是什么。
And therefore, what has been written in the Bible is sufficient for the church to understand and use them to preach the complete gospel of salvation.
所以记载在圣经里面的是足够让我们来传福音，然后 来告诉其他人的。
I want you to turn to Romans chapter 10.
我们看罗马书第十章。
We turn to Romans chapter 10.
罗马书第十章。
We read we can read verse 11 all the way down to verse 13.
11到13节。
Verse 11 to verse 13.
11到13节。
For the scriptures says, whoever believes on him will not be put to shame.
11节，经上说，凡信他的人必不至于羞愧。
Verse
12. 12节。
For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich to all who call upon him.
犹太人和希腊人并没有分别，因为众人同有一位主，他也厚待一切求告他的人。
Verse 13.
13节。
For whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
因为凡求告主名的就必得救。
I guess when you talk to your Christian friends, you know, or Christian from other denomination, many a time they would use verses 11 and 13 yeah, to support their belief.
那我们跟很多基督徒的朋友或是基督徒其他教派的来谈的时候，他们常常会来引用11节、13节。
They claim that as long as you believe on Jesus, in him, then you shall be saved, you shall not be put to shame.
那他们来说，来宣称说，这里说信他的人必不至羞愧，只要信靠主的就必得救。
Like what is you know, recorded in verse 11 and verse 13.
那就是11节、13节这里说的。
In fact, what they said is correct, you know.
其实他们说的是对的。
But we need to explain to them.
但是我们要进一步来解释。
Now, when you look at verse 11,
当我们看11节的时候,
we know that this verse is quoted from Isaiah chapter 28.
这是以赛亚书28章所记载的。
There is a background to that.
是有一个背景的。
We turn to chapter 28.
我们看以赛亚书28章。
We read verse 16. Yeah? Chapter 28, verse 16.
28章16节。
And therefore, thus says the Lord God, Behold, I lay in Zion a stone for a foundation, a try stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation, whoever believes will not act hastily.
所以主耶和华如此说，看哪，我在锡安放一块石头作为根基，是试验过的石头，是稳固根基、宝贵的房角石。信靠着的必不着急。
The last part of verse 16 is quoted by Paul, but with some modification.
那所以这一节的最后一句呢，保罗来引用，但是不就是有修，不是原文。
But when you look at this verse, you find that the writer first talks about Zion.
但是这边呢，我们看到这个作者呢，首先提到锡安。
So whoever believe on him will not be put to shame, meaning whoever believe on him in Zion shall not be put to shame.
所以十一节说，凡信他的人必不至于羞愧，指的是凡在锡安里面的人。
So if you are not part of the Mount Zion, then obviously your belief is not deemed right in the eyes of God.
所以如果你不属于锡安的话，那你的信仰在神眼中并不是有这个合法的。
Meaning that you know you must first be chosen by God.
就是你首先要被神来拣选。
Only then when you show your faith in Jesus, then you shall be accepted and you will not be put to shame.
然后再来展现出你的信心的时候呢，你不会至于羞愧。
So when you look at verse 12,
所以我们看十二节。
In fact, verse 12 is about, you know, the church community.
那这里就是指着教会的这个团体里面。
Because in the church, after, you know, we are baptized into Christ, you find that there shall be no distinction, you know, between us and others.
在教会你受洗之后呢，我们彼此是没有任何的分别。
So in this case, it said between a Jew and Greek.
所以说十二节说犹太人和希腊人。
In fact, this can be found in the book of Galatians, chapter 3.
它是在加拉太书第三章也可以看到。
We can turn to chapter 3 of Galatians.
我们看加拉太书第三章。
We read verse 27.
27节。
For as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ, there is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, there is neither male nor female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. So here is talking about the church community.
所以这边就提到的就是这个教会的团体里面。
There is no distinction between the Jews and the Greek.
这个犹太人、希腊人之间是没有分别的。
Because they have all been baptized into Christ.
因为他们都已经受洗归入基督了。
Now, to be part of this community, baptism must be done correctly or biblically.
那你要进入这个团体呢，这个受洗呢，要来合乎圣经。
So you find that when we are in this community, we shall call upon the Lord and the Lord shall listen to us.
所以当我们在这个团体之中呢，我们来向神呼求，神就会来听从。
We turn back to Romans chapter 10.
我们看回来罗马书第十章。
The last part of verse 12 it says,
十二节的后面这样说。
For the same Lord over all is rich to all who call upon him.
众人同有一位主，他也厚待一切求告他的人。
Here we find that all who call upon him means all who are in Zion, who have been baptized into Christ.
一切求告他的人指的是所有在锡安他的山的人已经来受洗归入基督的人。
So you find that, you know, the doctrine of the church actually do not contradict any part of the Bible.
所以他教会教义不会跟任何圣经上有抵触。
In fact, you know, the doctrine of the church, like in this case, baptism, can fit very well into the context of chapter 10 as well. Romans chapter 10.
在我们像我们这个讲到洗礼的这个教训呢，在罗马书十章也是很好，可以很好的来看到。
Now we look at verse 13.
看十三节。
For whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
因为凡求告主名的就必得救。
Meaning that you must be in Mount Zion to call upon the name of the Lord.
就是你要在锡安山来求告主名。
In this way, you can be saved.
那这样的话，你就必得救。
There are two verses that I want to show you.
那我们想来看两个经节。
We turn to Joel chapter 2.
我们看约珥书第二章。
We read verse
32. 32节。
Joel chapter 2, verse 32.
约珥书二章三十二节。
And it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
到那时，凡求告耶和华名的，就必得救。
This is like an exact quotation, yeah. When you look at, I mean, Paul directly quoted from this verse.
我们就看到这个保罗呢，也是来引用这一节。
But there is a second part to this verse, according to Joel.
但是在约珥书呢，这一句话后面还没完，还没结束。
That is, again, it said, for in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there shall be deliverance, and the Lord has said among the remnant whom the Lord calls.
在锡安山耶路撒冷必有逃脱人，在就是在这里呢，神求告神名的就必得救。
So there must be a connection between Mount Zion for those who call upon the name of the Lord.
所以呢，在锡安山跟那些求告神的名是有相关联的。
So meaning if you are not connected to Mount Zion, you know, your calling on the name of the Lord will not be effective.
就是呢，如果你没有跟锡安山连结，你求告神的就不会有回复。
In the New Testament time,
在新约的时候，
calling on the name of the Lord takes effect, yeah, when a person is baptized.
那求告神的名会得到回复呢，是因为当你的洗礼呢是有功效的。
Takes effect.
那就有功效。
We turn to Acts chapter 22.
我们看使徒行传二十二章。
We turn to Acts chapter 22.
使徒行传二十二章。
We read verse 16.
十六节。
Acts 22 verse 16.
二十二章十六节。
And now why are you waiting? Arise and be baptized and wash away your sins, calling on the name of the Lord.
现在你为什么单言呢？起来，求告他的名，受洗，洗去你的罪。
So, you know, from this example, it's quite clear that, you know, the doctrine of baptism of the true Jesus Church does not contradict, you know, any part of the Bible.
所以这一节就很清楚看到，耶稣教会的教义，这个洗礼呢，没有跟圣经 来背逆。
Because the patterns is given by God.
这个规模呢，已经神是神告诉我们的。
So if you want to explain the doctrine of the church,
所以如果你想要解释教会的教义，
first you must believe that the doctrines, you know, of the church, came from the Lord.
你首先要相信这些教义是从神来的。
So in this way, God will help you, yeah, will enable you to see. More and more clearly concerning the doctrine of the church.
那这样的话，神就会来帮你，让你更清楚的看到这个我们的教义。
We are going to take a few. We are going to take a break. Yeah.
那我们现在来休息一下。
We say a silent prayer.
请大家同心默祷。
Amen.
Amen.
So be back in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak. We mentioned that the doctrines of the church are the foundation of the church.
我们刚提到教会的教义是教会的根基。
Judging from Isaiah, you know, the foundation is laid by God himself.
根据以赛亚书呢，这个根基是神所亲自设立的。
We turn back to Isaiah chapter 28.
我们看回来以赛亚书二十八章。
Isaiah chapter 28.
以赛亚书二十八章。
We read verse 16.
十六节。
Therefore, thus says the Lord God, Behold, I lay in Zion a stone for a foundation, a tried stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. Whoever believes will not act hastily.
所以主耶和华如此说，看哪，我在锡安放一块石头作为根基，是试验过的石头，是稳固根基宝贵的房角石，信靠的人必不着急。
We know that the stone here refers to Jesus Christ.
我们知道这个石头指的就是耶稣基督。
Some people make questions.
那有人就直问，
How is Jesus related to the foundation of the church? Or how is Jesus related to the truth?
这个耶稣基督怎么连接到这个石头，怎么连接到这个真理呢？
Now, Paul once said,
那保罗曾经说，
We turn to Ephesians chapter 4.
我们看以弗所书第四章。
Ephesians chapter 4.
以弗所书第四章。
We read verse 21. The Chinese version is slightly different.
二十一节中文有点不一样。
Okay, my version says, if indeed you have heard him and have been taught by him, now the last part is say, as the truth is in Jesus.
所以说，如果你们听过他的道理呢，他的教，学了他的真理，然后原文就英文就是说，这个真理就是在耶稣里。
So Jesus is the foundation.
耶稣是这个根基。
He is the giver of the doctrines of the church.
他是赏赐根基，赏赐这个教义给教会的。
Therefore, you find that, you know, when you remove the doctrine of the church, it is likened to you removing Jesus from the church.
所以如果你将这个教义呢，从教会当中移去，等于是说你将这个基督，将耶稣来移除。
It is like saying that you do not want Jesus to be the foundation anymore.
就是说你不要再以耶稣为你的基这个根基了。
That's why but Paul sternly warns the church at Corinth.
那所以呢，保罗呢来严严的警告哥林多的教会。
Return to 1 Corinthians chapter 3.
你看哥林多前书第三章。
We read verse 11.
十一节。
Chapter 3, verse 11.
第三章十一节。
For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ.
因为那已经立好的根基就是耶稣基督，此外没有人能立别的根基。
So this foundation is given by God.
所以这个根基是神所赐的。
We say it's laid by God himself through his chosen workers.
神是亲自呢以他拣选的工人呢来立下这个根基。
Just like when you look at the foundation of the early church.
就看我们这个早期教会的这个根基。
No doubt it is laid by the Lord Jesus.
毫无疑问就是耶稣来所立下的。
But through his workers.
是借着他的工人来做。
Through the apostles.
借着使徒来做。
If you study the church at Corinth,
如果我们来研读这个哥林多教会，
who preached the gospel to the Corinthian believers?
是谁将这个福音传给哥林多的信徒呢？
It was Paul.
是保罗。
In Acts chapter 18, we are told that God asked him to remain in Corinth to preach the gospel.
在使徒行传十八章呢，神要保罗留在哥林多来传福音。
Now I want you to read verse 10, chapter 3, verse 10.
三章第十节。
According to the grace of God which was given to me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation. And another builds on it, but let each one take heed how he builds on it.
十节，我照神所给我的恩，好像一个聪明的工头，立好的根基，有别人在上面建造，只是个人要谨慎怎样在上面建造。
You know that God laid the foundation of the church at Corinth.
我们知道神立下了哥林多教会的根基。
Through Paul.
是借着保罗。
That's why Paul said, "I have laid the foundation."
因此说保罗说，我立下这根基。
So, you know, because he preached the truth, the complete truth of God, yeah, to the church at Corinth.
因为他将这全备的真理来传给哥林多教会。
One thing we need to understand.
有一件我们要理解的事情。
If we move away from this right foundation,
如果我们从这个正确的根基来离开的话，
there is no way that we can explain the Bible clearly.
那我们是绝对无法来清楚的解释圣经。
If we do not believe, you know, that this foundation is from God,
如果我们不相信这个根基是神所立的，
and the more you explain the Bible, the more, how can I say, the more you will be drifting further away from the truth.
那你就是你越解释这个圣经，你离真理是离越远的。
Now, you know, that's why it is important for us to understand that, you know, our mind must be shaped by the doctrines of the church.
那所以呢，我们要清楚知道说，我们的心思是要以神的这个教义来塑造的。
Now, I give you a very simple example. If you believe in Calvinism,
那比如说一个例子，如果你相信这个加尔文主义，
you know he came from the Protestant.
那他是从改革中而来的。
So you know you find that those who if you come from, you know, a Protestant background,
那如果你有这个改革中的这个背景的话，
you don't believe in baptism.
你是不信洗礼的。
You don't believe that baptism saves.
那你就也不信这个洗礼有功
效。You only believe that you are saved through faith, meaning you just believe in Jesus and you don't need to do anything else, yeah, and then you are saved.
所以呢，你只是相信呢，只要信了你就得救了。
But we find that Calvin was only a man.
但是我们发现这个加尔文他是一个人。
In fact, his teaching was very detached from the teaching of the apostles.
那他的这个教导呢，是跟这个使徒的是相差非常远的。
They emphasize the law on justification by faith.
他们的这个主张呢，这个是
因信称义。因信称义。
You
know, they really don't believe that baptism saves.
他完全不相信这个洗礼可以使人得救。
But for us, we are different.
但是我们不一样。
We believe that baptism saves.
我们相信呢，受洗使人得救。
We also believe that a person is justified by faith.
那我们也相信因信称义。
You say, how can you reconcile the two?
那你又想说这两个怎么样，怎么能够合起来呢？
Now I want you to read the verse. Yeah.
那我们来看一个经节。
We turn to the book of Romans.
你看罗马书。
We turn to the book of Romans, chapter 4.
罗马书第四章。
Now we read verse 25.
25节。
Verse 25.
25节。
Who was delivered up because of our offenses? Now, pay attention to the last part. It says, and was raised because of our justification.
耶稣被交给人是为我们的过犯复活，是为叫我们称义。
Now, so you find that, yeah, justification actually is connected to Christ being raised.
所以这里称义呢，是跟神复活是连在一起的。
You know, our justification is connected to Christ being raised.
但是我们的称义呢，是因为耶稣复活。
How is that connected?
那这怎么连在一起呢？
Now, first we need to understand the term justification.
那我们首先要来明白这个称义这个词。
It means to make righteous.
那就是使人来得称被称为义。
Meaning, you know, a person is without sin when he is made righteous.
那就是被称义，就是那个人是被称为无罪的。
So, how can that be possible, or when does that happen?
那所以一个人怎么称义？那是什么时候被称义呢？
Here we find that this verse give us a clue.
那所以这一节给我们一个这个讯息。
Meaning that we must be raised together with Christ.
那就是我们要跟耶稣一同复活。
So that's why when Christ was raised,
所以当耶稣复活的时候,
it's for our justification.
那是为了我们称义而做的。
Because when we believe in Jesus, when we are baptized correctly,
那所以当我们信耶稣，我们做对的事,
baptized correctly,
当我们用正确的方法来受洗,
then our sins are forgiven.
那我们的罪就得赦。
We become justified.
那我们就被称义了。
So that's why in Acts chapter 2, verse 38, it says, baptism is for the remission of sin.
那所以, 使徒行传2章28节告诉我们呢, 受洗是为了洗去我们的罪。
So in this light, you find that again, the doctrine of baptism does not contradict the teachings of justification by faith.
所以看到这个洗礼的教义也没有跟因信称义来这个抵触。
Because our foundation is correct.
因为我们这个根基是正确的。
Because our premise is given to us, the premise of our faith is given to us by God.
因为我们的信仰的根基就是神所立下来的。
That's why we are very blessed and we are very thankful to God for what he has done for us.
我们真的很感谢神，然后也所赏赐给我们的。
I guess I want to spend a bit of time here to talk about how to read, you know, the prophetic books in the Old Testament scriptures.
那我想要花点时间来讨论说，要怎么来研读这旧约的这个预言书。
Many of us, you know, do not want to read the prophetic too much because, after all, we find that they are not easily understandable.
那有时候我们不太想去读这个预言书或去解释，因为 有时候是很蛮难去来解释的。
Because it's like when you read the prophetic book, sometimes you know a certain part of it talks about you know some historical facts.
因为某些这个预言书呢，会谈到或是跟讲到这个历史的一些事实。
You find that other parts are talking about things that we cannot really associate with easily.
那某些部分可能是我们现在比较没办法来理解的事情。
We know that many of the Old Testament scriptures are prophecies.
那我们知道旧约呢，很多的部分呢都是预言。
I just want you to look at a number of verses in the New Testament.
那我们先看这个新约的几个经节。
We turn to first we turn to James chapter 5.
我们看雅各书第五章。
We turn to the book of James chapter 5.
看雅各书第五章。
We read verse 10, yeah.
第十节。
Chapter 5 verse 10.
五章第十节。
My brethren, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord as an example of suffering and patience.
弟兄们，你们要把那先前奉主名说话的众先知当作能受苦、能忍耐的榜样。
Here it gives us a direction as to how we should read, you know, the prophetic books.
那这里告诉我们呢，这个要怎么来读预言书的一个方向。
You find that here we should learn from the example of sufferings and patience.
那就是说呢，我们要来效法他们受苦忍耐的榜样。
If you read the prophetic books, you only learn about historical facts.
那如果你读预言书，你如果只学到这个历史的事件。
If you only try to find out more about, you know, how can I say, the history of the chosen people of God.
啊，如果你只是想要来找出这选民的这个历史的事迹，
then in reality you have not really learned anything from it.
啊，其实你从中其实没有学到什么教训。
So you should be able to learn, you know, good examples of suffering and patience of the prophets.
那我们应该是能够从这些众先知来学习忍耐受苦的榜样。
Now we turn to Romans.
那我们来看罗马书。
We turn to Romans.
罗马书。
We read chapter 15. Yeah.
罗马书第十五章。
Romans chapter 15.
罗马书第十五章。
We read verse 4.
我们看第四节。
For whatever things were written before were written for our learning, that we through the patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
从前所写的圣经都是为教训我们写的，叫我们因圣经所生的忍耐和安慰可以得着盼望。
Quite clearly, the summary given here is that the Old Testament scriptures is written for our learning. We can learn a lot of lessons from the Old Testament scriptures.
那所以告诉我们一个这个总结呢，说我们这个旧约呢是要让我们来学习这些忍耐和安慰。
We can learn a lot of lessons from it.
那从中可以学习到很多教训。
It means that, you know, every prophecy is like with many teachings attached.
那就是呢，这些预言书呢，都是有很多的教训来附着在上面的。
Or every teachings in the Old Testament scriptures is with many meanings.
那旧约的每个教训都是有意义的。
Since we are talking about prophecies,
那既然我们在说到这个预言，
I guess there's one point that we need to bear in mind.
那有一点我们要谨记。
I want you to turn to Amos. Yeah.
我们来看阿摩斯书。
We turn to Amos.
我们看阿摩斯书。
We read chapter 9.
我们看第九章。
Amos chapter 9.
阿摩斯书第九章。
Verse 11 and verse 12.
11, 12节。
I mention these two verses because they are used as one of the supports, yeah, for the doctrine of the one true church.
那我提到这两节是因为呢，它是我们其中一个教义的一个这个支持的经节。
Now we read verse 11.
我们看11节。
On that day I will raise up the tabernacle of David, which has fallen down, and repair its damages.I will raise up its ruins and rebuild it as in the days of old.
到那日，我必建立大卫倒塌的帐幕，堵住其中的破口，把那破坏的建立起来，重新修造，像古时一样。
Verse 12.
十二节。
That they may possess the remnants of Edom and all the Gentiles who are called by my name, says the Lord who does these things.
以色列人得以东所余剩的和所有称为我名下的国，此乃行这事的耶和华说的。
You find that some people, you know, raise some question to challenge, you know, the verses we use. These two verses we use to support our belief on the one true church.
那有人就用这个呢来挑战说我们独一真教会的这个教义。
And they say that this part of the scriptures has been fulfilled in Acts chapter 15.
那他们说呢，这一节的这个预言呢，已经在《使徒行传》十五章来预成实现了。
Because when James talk about this, he is talking about Jesus Christ has come, you know, to save, and meaning that you know by relying on the law, yet the law cannot save.
那就是说呢，来靠着基督呢，能够来得救。
靠着律法不能得救。
靠着律法无法得救。
Okay, we turn to Acts chapter 15.
我们看使徒行传十五章。
Verse 16 and verse 17.
十六节、十七节。
Are the quotation from Amos chapter 9, verse 11 and verse 12.
这个就是来引用阿摩斯书九章十一、十二节。
Now, does it mean that Amos chapter 9, verse 10 and verse 11 and verse 12 cannot be used on the true Jesus church?
那这也有代表说阿摩斯书九章十一十二节无法引用在真耶稣教会吗？
Now, just now we have read, yeah?
那我们刚刚才读过嘛。
What is written is for our learning.
那我们所读的是为了教训所得。
Is for the apostle to learn.
是的，是让使徒去学习。
Is also for us to learn.
那也是让我们学习。
If this verse applies to the apostle,
如果这两节经节来是应用在使徒身上，
surely this section of the scriptures must also be applied on us.
那这两节也是能够应用在我们身上。
Like what we have mentioned before, you know, a prophecy is with many layers of meaning.
那我们刚说到这个预言呢，是有很多层的这个意义的。
Just like, you know, when we read the Acts chapter 13. Yeah?
就像我们刚读，就是读这个《使徒行传》十三章。
You know, Paul quoted an example of Jesus Christ.
那这个保罗呢，来引用了耶稣基督的这个话。
Rather, he quoted an example which is on Jesus.
他没有用耶稣的这个
He quoted an example, a prophecy which is used on Jesus.
那他是用这个实现在耶稣上的这个预言。
But he referred that prophecy to himself and to the apostles.
他指着这个预言在他的身应用在他身上。
We can read the Acts chapter 13.
我们看《使徒行传》十三章。
Verse 47.
四十七节。
He said, For so the Lord has commanded us.
因为主曾这样吩咐我们说。
Us refers to the apostles.
我们指的就是使徒。
But also, to also refers to the true Jesus Church, the end time true church.
那也指着我们末世真教会的信徒说。
But when you look at the quotation,
那是他这里所引用的经节。
It is from Isaiah.
那就是引用在以赛亚书。
You find that Isaiah chapter 49.
以赛亚书四十九章。
It is used on Jesus.
是用在耶稣的身上。
But Paul uses this verse to apply to the apostle.
但是呢，保罗引用这个经节是指着那个些使徒说的。
But surely we can also use this verse to apply it to the true Jesus church.
那我们也同样也能用这个经节来指着我们真教会信徒说。
So meaning a prophecy can have, or we said, is with many layers of meaning attached.
那就是这个预言书呢，是可以有很多层的意义来指着来去引用的。
So when we use Amos chapter 9,
所以当我们引用阿摩斯书第九章,
to say that, you know, the fallen tabernacle of David has been rebuilt,
当我们说这个大卫倒塌的帐幕已经被重建,
that refers to the rebuilding of the apostolic church in the end time.
指的是来重建使徒教会的, 在末世重建使徒教会。
That teaching is accurate.
那这个教训是正确的。
On top of that, the church has the spirit of prophecy.
而且呢，这个教会上呢，有这个有真理。
真理的灵魂。
有真理的灵。
There is no contradiction.
那是没有来抵触的。
In fact, we are rebuilding the fallen apostolic church.
那其实我们就是在重建这使徒教会的这个倒塌的使徒教会。
Now, I also want you to turn to 1 Peter.
那我们来看彼得前书。
We turn to 1 Peter chapter 1.
彼得前书第一章。
We read verse 9, yeah?
我们看第九节。
Chapter 1, verse 9.
一章九节。
Receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your souls.
并且得着你们信心的果效，就是灵魂的救恩。
Verse 10.
十节。
Of this salvation, the prophets have inquired and searched carefully, who prophesied of the grace that would come to you.
论到这救恩，那预先说你们要得恩典的众先知，早已详细的寻求考察。
We read verse 11.
11节,
searching what or what manner of time the Spirit of Christ was in them, was indicating when he testified beforehand the sufferings of Christ and the glories that would follow.
就是考察在他们心里基督的灵预先证明基督受苦难后来得荣耀是指着什么时候 并怎样的时候。
Verse 12.
12节,
to them it was revealed that not to themselves but to us they were ministering the things which now have been reported to you through those who have preached the gospel to you by the Holy Spirit sent from heaven, things which angels desire to look into.
他们得了启示，知道他们所传讲的一切事不是为自己，乃是为你们，那靠着从天上差来的圣灵传福音给你们的人，现在将这些事报给你们，天使也愿意详细查看这些事。
There are quite a number of main points here that we need to look at very closely.
那这里有几项我们要来仔细看的。
One of the things is about the salvation of the souls.
那第一个就是灵魂的救恩。
Concerning this salvation, you find that the prophets, meaning the Old Testament prophets, have inquired and searched carefully into.
关于这个救恩呢，这个旧约的众先知已经详细的考察。
God has revealed to them.
那神向他你来显现。
Now I want you to look at verse 12.
我们看十二节。
To them it was revealed that not to themselves but to us.
那他们得的启示不是为自己，而是为你们。
To us mean to the church.
那我们指的就是这个教会。
So you find that the prophecies in the Old Testament are for us, are for the church.
所以旧约的预言是为了我们，就是为了教会。
Particularly your prophecies concerning salvation.
特别是指着这个救恩的预言。
When we talk about salvation, there are two main points that we cannot neglect.
说到救恩呢，有两点不可以来忽略的。
The first is Jesus Christ himself.
第一个就是耶稣基督。
Second is his body, the church.
再来就第二个就是他的身体，就是教会。
These two are closely connected.
这两个是息息相关的。
You cannot just talk about the church without Jesus.
我们不能只谈教会不谈基督。
And vice versa. You cannot just talk about Jesus yet without mentioning his chosen people.
反之亦然，你不可只讲到耶稣不谈到神的选民。
So in this light, we can see that, you know, the prophecies of the Old Testament scriptures are for us.
我们就看到旧约的预言是为我们而说而启示的。
We say that the prophecies of the Old Testament scriptures are transcendent. It transcends time and space.
那所以这个旧约的启示呢，是超乎时间跟空间。
So it points to the end time true church.
是指着末世真教会而已。
So when you read the Old Testament scriptures, you must always bear these two points in mind.
所以我们读旧约的时候要记住这两点。
You must not just focus yourself on history or the historical background, you know, of the chapter or passage that you are searching into.
我们不能只是查考或者只看到这我们所研读的这一章的这个历史的这个事迹而已。
You find that even Peter himself says that.
其实彼得他也这样子说。
In the book of Acts, yeah.
就是他在这个使徒行传的时候。
We turn to Acts chapter 10.
我们看使徒行传第十章。
Acts chapter 10.
使徒行传第十章。
And to see how the prophecies of the prophets are connected to our salvation.
那我们看这个旧约的这个预言怎么来与我们的救恩来连结。
We read chapter 10.
我们看第十章。
You know that chapter 10, Peter was sent to... Cornelius to preach to him and his household.
第十章的神差派呢，彼得去向哥林流一家来传道。
We read verse 43.
我们看四十三节。
To him, mean to Jesus, all the prophets witness that through his name, whoever believes in him will receive remission of sin.
众先知也为他就是耶稣做见证说，凡信他的人必因他的名得蒙赦罪。
You find that the summary here given by Peter surely was inspired by God.
这里彼得所说的这个也是为耶稣所 做的见证。
The summary here given by Peter.
这里彼得所说的 这个结论。
Actually is from the Holy Spirit, is the inspiration of the Holy Spirit.
是圣灵所给他的启示。
So he could see that, you know, the prophets,Many of the prophets, in fact, he said all the prophets, talks about, you know, believing in Jesus for the remission of sin.
所以众先知就是所有的先知也为耶稣来做见证，说信他的名可以得赦罪。
So that's why we said that, you know, the prophecies, the prophet, the words of the prophets are the foundation of the church.
所以这个先知的话，这个预言就是教会的根基。
Because they are inspired by the Lord.
于是神所默示的
to speak the word not for themselves but for us.
所说的这些话不是为他们，是为我们而说的。
So when you read the Old Testament scriptures, this is something that you need to bear in mind.
所以我们读旧约的时候就要有这样子的这个知识。
I want to show you another example. Yeah.
我们想要再看另外一个例子。
We turn to the book of Daniel.
我们看但以理书。
We turn to the book of Daniel.When you look at chapter 8, yeah,
第八章的地方,
chapter 8 is talking about, you know, the main focus is on the vision of the ram and the goat.
主要就是讲这个公绵羊跟公山羊的意象。
Later on, you find that Gabriel, you know, came to give understanding to Daniel.
那后来我们就看到
We read verse 16.
加百列就是要使他明白的意象。
The archangel came to Daniel to make him understand.
这个天使长了要让他明白这个意象。
Okay, if you read verse 20,
我们看第二十节。
The ram which you saw having the two horns, they are the kings ofMedia and Persia.
你所看见双脚的公绵羊就是马代和波斯王。
Verse 21.
二十一节。
And the male goat is the kingdom of Greece. The large horn that is between its eyes is the first king.
那公山羊就是希腊王，两眼当中的大脚就是头一王。
It seems that, you know, Gabriel, when he came, he like, how can I say it?Give understanding to Daniel, but within a certain frame, yeah.
那就好像这个加百列来解释的时候，他是在某一个框架下来解释这个意象。
This is historical to all of us. This is historical. Because we said, you see, that's why we need to look at this chapter from a historical perspective.
所以我们说，哦，我们要看这个是以一个历史的角度去看。
Now the question we need to ask is this.
但是呢，我们要问一个问题。
Is Daniel or is Gabriel only talking about history here?
就是但以理还有这个加百列在这里只是谈单单谈到历史而已吗？
What is its relevance to us?
那这个跟我们现在有什么相关？
No, we need to understand the scriptures is written for our learning.
那我们要明白说圣经是为我们教训我们而写的。
In fact, all the prophets, all right, like what we have read, yeah, talk about things pertaining to salvation.
就像我们刚刚读的这个众先知都是写着是为着救恩来所写的。
Now it seems that here the framework is within the historical setting in the time of Daniel.
那这边看似的这个框架是指着但以理那时的历史的那个时间来说。
Because we know that after the after Babylon, then it came the Medes and Persia.
我们知道是历史上的这个在巴比伦的王国之后，再来就是马代和波斯。
In fact, you find that you know Daniel lived through this you know these dynasties.
那这个但以理也是来活过这几个这个王朝。
Now, at the same time, we also find that Gabriel did not just mention history.
但是呢，同时间也看到加百列，他不是单单指着历史说。
I want you to read verse 16. Yeah.
我们看16节。
The second part is saying Gabriel. Make this man understand the vision.
然后后面说呢，加百列啊，要使人明白这异象。
Now, verse 17, this is what Gabriel said to Daniel.
17节是他对但以理说的话。
Though he came near where I stood and where he came, I was afraid and fell on my face. But he said to me, understand, understand, son of man, that the vision refers to the time of the end.
第七节，他便来到我所站的地方，他一来我就惊惶伏伏在地。他对我说：“人子啊，你要明白，因为这是关乎末后的意象。”
So the vision is about the time of the end.
所以这个意象讲的是关乎末后的事情。
Now we read verse 19.
19节。
And he said, "Look, I'm making known to you what shall happen in the latter time of the indignation, for at the appointed time, the end shall be."
说我要指示你恼怒临定必有的事，因为这是关乎末后的定期。
So again, it points to the future, not so much to the time of Daniel.
所以这个是指着但以理的未来，不是当时的事时候。
Verse 26.
26节。
And the vision of the evenings and mornings which was told is true, therefore seal up the vision, for it refers to many days in the future.
所说2300日的意象是真的，但你要将这意象封住，因为关乎后来许多的日子。
Again, it points to the future.
一样是指着未来后来的日子而言。
Now, think about this, yeah?
那我们这样子来看。
There are two layers.
那有两层的意义。
One is historical, which is stated in verse 20.
那就是第一个，这是历史上的意义，就是在二十节说。
So meaning, you know, this prophecy, you know, has, if I can put it this way, has its roots in history.
就是说呢，这个预言是有历史的这个根基的这个根的。
However, the main thing is not about history itself.
但是它主要的重点不是这个历史。
Because it points to the future.
因为它是要来指着未来而说。
Now, what exactly does it mean then?
所以到底是什么意思?
It means the prophecy is rooted in history, yes?
就是说，没错，这个预言是以这个历史为根。
But history is only a shadow.
但是历史只是一个影。
The substance is what is about things that will happen in the future, in the church.
但是这个本质呢，是指着未来，就是指着未来的教会而言。
So meaning God is using historical facts in a prophetic way to tell us about what will happen to the church in the future.
啊，就是呢，神用这个历史的事件来指着说未来教会你们会发生的事情。
Yeah, so when you look at it in this way,
啊，所以如果我们用这个角度来看，
then it will not contradict any part of the Bible.
啊，不是不会跟这个圣经上的任何的地方有抵触。
Many a time you find that, you know, prophecies are not just about history.
很常常我们看这个预言不是只 单看到这个历史事件。
Let me give you a very simple example. Yeah?
那我们来看一个很简单的例子。
We turn to the book of Micah.
我们看弥迦书。
We turn to the book of Micah.
我们看弥迦书。
We read the chapter 5.
第五章。
Chapter 5.
第五章。
We read verse 6.
第六节。
They shall waste with the sword the land of Assyria and the land of Nimrod at its entrance. Thus he shall deliver us from the Assyrians when he comes into our land and when he treads within our borders.
他们必用刀剑毁坏亚述地和尼禄地的关口。亚述人进入我们的地境践踏的时候，他必拯救我们。
The question is, how would God deliver us, deliver the people?
那问题是神怎么来拯救百姓？
When you read verse 5,
我们看到第五节。
And this one shall be peace when the Assyrian comes into our land and when he treads in our palaces, then we will raise against him 7 shepherds and 8 princely men.
这位必作我们的平安，当亚述人进入我们的地境践踏宫殿的时候，我们就立起7个牧者8个首领攻击他。
In the history of the chosen people, we cannot find this, you know. This part of the history, we say that, you know, there were 7 shepherds and 8 priestly men who came up to defend, you know, his own people, their own people.
这个选民的历史，我们看不到这个七个牧者、八个首领这个东西。
So it has to be, you know, a teaching that need to be looked at from a spiritual perspective.
所以这个教训是要从属灵的角度来看的。
Meaning that God will raise up, you know, a people who are good in faith.
所以神会兴起有信心的人。
To defend against those who oppose, you know, the church.
来抵挡那些来攻击教会的人。
You know, they are represented, you know, by the Assyrians and the Babylonians.
然后他们就是亚述巴比伦的这个代表。
So.You know, this is how you look at it.
所以这是我们要这样子来解释。
If you say, oh, this has to be history.
如果说啊，这个你指的这个就是历史。
Then how are you going to explain this?
那你要怎么解释这里呢？
It will become very difficult. Yeah.
就很难去解释它。
Okay. Now, one more point.
再来一点。
You know that even when you look at the prophecies, you know the prophecy has a pattern. So.
即使在看预言书的时候，预言也有它的一个规模。
Even the law is given, you know, in the form.
那这个律法呢，也是有一个规模在的。
We turn to Romans.
我们看罗马书。
Romans chapter 2.
罗马书第二章。
We read verse 20.
二章二十节。
Romans chapter 2 verse 20.
二章二十节。
An instructor of the foolish, a teacher of babes, having the form of knowledge and truth in the law.
是蠢笨人的师父，是小孩子的先生，在律法上有知识和真理的模范。
When Moses, for example, taught the law of God, obviously he has to teach, you know, in a way that God has given to him, to the people.
所以当摩西在讲述这个律法的时候，他要来讲述神所教导他的这些东西。
It has to come in the form.
它是有一个模范规模的。
Otherwise, it will become very confusing.
那不然会非常的很模糊。
No one will be able to, you know, easily understand, you know, what Moses, you know, has said.
那要不然没有人很清楚知道摩西在谈论什么。
So when you look at the prophecy of the scriptures, it's the same.
所以当我们看这个旧约的预言也是一样。
It is given in a pattern.
它是以一个模范来去讲述的。
And this pattern is first given to the church.
那这个模范是首先神来告诉教会。
Now, again, let me just give you a very simple example.
那一样，那我们来看一个很简单的例子。
We turn to like Isaiah.
我们看以赛亚书。
We turn to the book of Isaiah.
我们看以赛亚书。
We look at chapter 11.
11章。
Isaiah chapter 11.
以赛亚书第11章。
Now we look at this chapter actually can be divided into two parts.
那这一章呢，可以分成两段来看。
The first part is from verse 1 to verse 9.
那第一段是1到9节。
It talks about Jesus Christ.
那这里谈到耶稣基督。
And the work that he would do.
还有他要做的工。
And how he would perfect, he would make the holy mountain perfect.
那他会怎么样使圣山来成为完全。
Now, when you read from verse 10 to verse 16,
那第二段是10到16节。
Again, it talks about the work of Christ, the work of God in building his church.
那就是神的工作呢, 要来建立起教会。
Now, when you read verse 10, it talks about Jesse. The root of Jesse obviously is Christ.
那这里十节讲到耶稣的根就是指耶稣。
How do we know? Some people may question, how do you know that this passage is talking about the church?
那有人就会说，那你怎么知道这一节在讲的是教会呢？
There are two key points here.
那这里有两个重点。
Now we read verse 10. Apart from Jesus, it says, Jesus shall stand, or the root of Jesse shall stand as a banner to the people.
那十节说呢，耶稣的根必立作万民的大旗。
For the Gentiles shall seek him, and his resting place shall be glorious.
外邦人必寻求他，他安息之所大有荣耀。
Now, the resting place here refers to Mount Zion, the chosen dwelling place of God.
安息之所指的是锡安山，神所这个居之处。
We turn to Psalms.
你看诗篇。
132.
132篇。
The book of Psalms, 132.
诗篇132篇。
We read verse 13 and we read the 13 and 14 and 13 and 14.
34节。
For the Lord has chosen Zion, he has desired it for his dwelling place. This is my resting place forever. Here I will dwell, for I have desired it.
第三节，因为耶和华拣选了锡安，愿意当作自己的居所，说这是我永远安息之所，我要住在这里，因为是我所愿意的。
Meaning that you know the church of God shall become glorious.
就是神的教会会成为荣耀的地方。
The banner refers, according to Psalms chapter 60 verse 4, is a mean by which the truth of God is displayed.
那这个大旗呢，指的就是呢真理所。 所宣扬的地方。
Chapter 60 verse 4, Psalms, yeah.
诗篇,
chapter 60 verse 4.
第四节。
Okay, now when you look at verse 11, it said it shall be done again the second time. Yeah? Second time to recover the remnant of his people.
那就是呢，第二次呢，神。Verse 11,
yeah. It shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time. Isaiah chapter 11.
以赛亚书十一章十。
Verse 11.
当那日主必二次伸手救回自己百姓中所余剩的。
Now we read verse 12.
12节,
he will set up a banner for the nation.
他必向列国树立大旗。
He has set before and he's going to do it again.
那他曾经设立过, 现在还要再做一次。
And the banner represents, you know, the truth.
那这个大旗指着真理。
Meaning the truth has been lost.
就是这个真理先前已经流失了。
That's why there is a need to be set up again.
那所以有必要再次树立起来。
So you know when you look at the prophecy, we believe that the church will appear in two time periods.
那所以我们看预言书，我们相信教会会在两个时期来建立。
We have been given this pattern.
那我们又给了这样的的模范。
When you read it, it makes sense to us.
那我们来研读的时候，我们就非常的合理。
So you find that yeah, our foundation must be from God.
所以我们的根基是要从神来的。
Meaning the foundation of the church is from God, and meaning the 10 basic beliefs must be our foundation.
就是呢，这个教会的根基是从神而来的。我们的十大的信仰呢，就是我们的根基。
So with this, we can understand the prophecy in the Bible.
我们这样子呢，就能明白这个预言的内容。
So what I have shared with you is very brief.
所以我所分享的是很简单的分享。
I have given you some tips and some direction to follow.
给了你们一些方向，一些诀窍来去行。
So hopefully in the future when you read the prophetic books, you can follow, you know, some of the points that I have raised.
希望之后你们在读预言书的时候，就可以照着这样的这个方法来研读。
So may God guide and bless all of you.
愿神来带领，来帮助大家。
Now we are going to pray together.
我们现在要一起祷告。